Hello students, as a part of indefinite integration, in our previous videos we learned different standard formulas and different standard tricks, and in the last class specifically we learned about integral e power x f of x dx as well integral e power x of f of x plus f dash x dx formula, and we did some problems related to that. After those we need to answer these questions, right? So integral of log h to the base e dx, integral of log x base e whole cube dx, as well integral 1 by log x base e dx, and then I am going to solve integral e power ax sin bx dx. Using this integral e power ax sin bx dx, I will generate some more tricks and some more problems I will solve. Okay, and before going to learn the tricks related to these problems, first of all, you all just like this video, as well do share it for your fellow aspirants, as well encourage your friends and your surroundings to support and to subscribe for this channel. Now look here, see, using these concepts now I am going to solve these questions. First problem, integral log x to the base e dx. See, we don't have that. Actually, we don't have a formula for integral of log x to the base e. Derivative of log x is 1 by x, okay? And integral of 1 by x is log x, okay? Don't get confused with the differentiation of log x as well integral of log x. Now we are calculating integral of log x. Actually, we don't have any direct formula. For that, to solve this, we need to take log x to the base e is equals to something, okay? To solve first bit of this 25, take log x to the base e is equals to some t. Since log x to the base e is equals to t, then x is equals to e power t. Okay, exponential form of that logarithm. So since x is equals to e power t, now I will try to convert the problem completely in terms of t from x. Since x is equals to e power t, you just differentiate it on both sides, then you will get that dx is equals to e power t dt. Just observe now, integral of log x to the base e dx is the problem, and now I am trying to convert the problem into t by taking log x base e as t. So this is integral of this log x to the base e as t, and dx is simply nothing but e power t dt. Now just what is this integral of e power t into dt dt? As we discussed in the last class, e power t t dt. So this is simply nothing but e power t into function t minus its derivative 1 plus c. Okay, as we discussed, integral of e power x into f of x dx is nothing but what? E power x into f of x minus f dash of x plus f double dash minus, like that. Okay, using the same trick, function is t and its derivative is 1. Okay, now since the given problem is in terms of x, we need to mention our answer also in terms of x. So convert it into x, e power t is x. So x into t means log x to the base e minus 1 plus c. At the end, integral of log x is x into log x to the base e minus 1 plus c. Not only this integral of log x to the base e dx, also these type of problems. Log x to the base e power 2, power 3, power 4, power 5, power anything. To answer these type of problems, we need to move by taking log x to the base e is equals to t. Okay, so the first problem, usually you need to memorize this integral of log x to the base e dx as x into log x to the base e minus 1 plus c as a formula. Okay, right. And now if you wish to answer this second bit, again use the same substitution. Now this is integral of log x to the base e whole cube. Since log x to the base e is t, so t cube into dx. What is dx? Dx is in the same way e power t dt. So now use same trick, e power t into t cube, then its result, as we discussed in the last class, e power t into the function t cube minus its derivative 3t square plus its derivative 16 minus its derivative 6, and then after you will get 0, so leave it there, plus some constant c. And now since it is in terms of t, but the question is in terms of x, you need to rewrite in terms of x. So this is equals to e power t is what? X and t cube in the sense log x to the base e whole cube minus 3 into log x to the base e whole square plus 6 into log x to the base e minus 6 plus c. Okay, that much simple, just by rewriting log x to the base e as t. Okay, after these two, you just write bit c and I will discuss. Now, so integral of log x is x into log x to the base e minus 1 plus c. Okay, and we solved the second bit also. Now, what you say about the third one? Again, use same substitution. See, this is equals to integral of 1 by log x to the base e as some t. 1 by t into dx is what? Dx is again e power t dt. So, 1 by t into e power t dt. Here again, we have to use the same trick as we discussed in the last class. E power t into function 1 by t minus its derivative minus 1 by t square. Okay, see, what is the derivative of 1 by t? Derivative of 1 by t is minus 1 by t square, and formula also has 1 minus, right? So plus 1 by t square, and then plus its derivative. What is the derivative? See, for minus 1 by t square, what is the derivative? For minus 1 by t square, the derivative is, okay, 2 by t cube, so plus 2 by t cube. And then we need to use its derivative again. What is its derivative? For 1 by t cube, the derivative is t power minus 3, so minus 3 by t power 4, and minus 1 minus plus 6 by t power 4 plus, and so on. Okay, so you will get an infinite series expansion here, infinite series result here. So e power t is basically x into 1 by t, in the sense 1 by log x base e plus 1 by t square, 1 by log x base e whole square plus 2 by t cube, 2 by log x base e whole cube plus, and so on. Okay, that's the answer. This is simply because of this particular formula, e power f of x into f of x minus its derivative f dash plus its derivative f double dash minus its derivative f triple dash plus, and so on. Here our, see, this is not e power f of x, this is just simply e power x. Here, our f of x is 1 by t. So, 1 by t, its derivative, and then like that. So, finally, this is our answer for this integral 1 by log x to the base e dx. Okay. But among these three, usually this is required to memorize for answering some questions. And now, you just think about the next useful and then somewhat beautiful trick, that is integral e power ax sin bx dx. First of all, I will derive this and then I will use it to answer some questions. Have a look. So, integral e power ax sin bx dx. Okay. Very useful and required result. So, we need to use, since we have two functions, we need to move with integration by parts. But I will use that integration by parts in a different way. First of all, you just take this complete problem as I. See, the integral value of this complete problem as some I. So, I is equals to integral e power ax sin bx dx. At the end of this discussion, our task is to mention this I only, because this integral we need to find and that integral value is I. So, integral e power ax sin bx dx, you just go with integration by parts since we have two functions. So, what is first function, what is other second function to apply? So, as you move with I late, e is the last letter, so exponential function is the second function, whereas this is the first function. Okay, so in other words, this sin bx is some f as well, this e power ax is t. Then what is its integral? So this is equals to f into integral z dx minus integral f dash into integral z dx, and this total part again integral with respect to x, right? And this is equals to what is f? F is sin bx. And now what you say about integral g dx? Can I write directly? G is e power ax. For e power x, its integration is e power x. For e power 2x, its integration is e power 2x by 2. And here we have e power ax. So integral of that e power ax is e power ax by a, okay, minus integral f dash. So what is f dash? Derivative of this sin bx. Again, I am writing directly. Derivative of sin is cos bx, but for bx we need to write b. So f dash is b cos bx into again integral of g, as we wrote there, e power ax by a dx, right? And now this is equals to sin bx, so into e power ax by a minus, you just write this constant out, b by a into integral cos bx into e power ax dx. Here we have cos bx into e power ax dx. Again we need to use integration by parts here. So now if you use integration by parts here, this is first function and that e power ax is the second function. Okay, now try to apply. Product of these two is nothing but e power ax by a sin bx minus b by a into, here I am going to use integration by parts again. So this cos dx is the first function, e power ax is the second function. See, since we are already trying to apply, use this integration by parts, I am going to write directly. First function cos bx into integral of this second function is e power ax by a minus integral of derivative of the first function. So derivative for the cos bx, derivative for the cos is minus sign and for bx is b. So this is minus b sin bx into integral of this e power ax is e power ax by a dx. Just observe everything. And now what will happen? Okay, from these two terms, so at the end what we have in our hands is I is equals to, this is all equal to our required integral value. I is equals to e power ax sin bx by a, e power ax sin bx by a, and the second term is minus b by a, and here again e power ax by, you just multiply this, then we have minus b cos bx into e power ax by a square, right? And now minus minus minus, see, since we have this term, we need to multiply with minus b by a, minus minus and then minus, that means three minuses, so it gives you one more minus, and then b by a, and again we have here b by a, that means b square by a square. So minus b square by a square into, just observe very carefully, okay, just pay your complete attention here. See, minus b by a, here again minus b by a, along with this minus will become minus b square by a square, okay. Now what is the remaining part? Remaining part is this integral of sin bx into e power ax. What? Integral of sin bx into e power ax is the given problem itself. That given problem is considered as I. So minus b square by a square into I is the remaining part. That's what we have at the end. I is equals to e power ax sin bx by a minus b cos bx e power ax by a square minus b square by a square into I again. But our task is to get the value of I. So send this minus b square a square by I this side. So I plus b square by a square into I is equals to, from these two terms you just pick out e power ax by a square as a common thing. You left with a sin bx minus b cos bx. Is there anything wrong? Nothing. Since we have a square in the denominator, but here only a, multiply with a both numerator and denominator, so you get a square denominator, okay? Right. So e power ax is common, a square is common. If you pick it out, a sin bx minus b cos bx is the term, right? And now this side, see, you just took LCM, a square of b square plus a square. See, at the end, my task is to cancel out the denominator a square by multiplying everything with a square. So we have I into b square plus a square, you will get. Just observe this, okay? I am going to write directly, okay? When you observe this part, this part will become I times of
b square plus a square by a square. Is it right? And now we have here e power ax by a square, right? This a square and this a square, you just cancel out. You left with I times of b square plus a square, and send that a square plus b square to the right side. Finally, we have I is equals to e power ax divided by a square plus b square into a sin bx minus b cos bx. That's our final answer. So, integral of e power ax sin bx dx is e power ax by a square plus b square into a sin bx minus b cos bx. Just it is by applying integration by parts for two times and with a simple algebraic calculation. Okay, have a look. You just observe perfectly, right? You just try this solution, or you may say proof, in your own way once again. And the solution of this problem in a descriptive way is also important for board examinations. Just observe now. See, integral e power ax sin bx dx, just we found it as e power ax divided by a square plus b square into a sin bx minus b cos bx. Is it right? A sin bx minus b cos bx. In the same way, if you try, if you prove, this integral e power ax cos bx is nothing but e power ax divided by a square plus b square. This part is same. And now here it is a cos bx plus b sin bx. Just have a look. This is e power ax by a square plus b square, a sin bx minus b cos bx. And now this is a cos bx plus b sin bx. Since this is sin bx is involved, first term with a is sin bx. Since cos bx is involved, first term with a is cos bx. Okay. Now use this to answer these type of questions. Integral e power x sin x dx. So when you compare this e power x sin x with this e power ax sin bx, see, look there, a value is 1, as well look there, b value is also 1. So to answer this problem, you need to take a as 1 and b as 1 in the first result. Okay, this is our observation. Okay, a is equals to 1 and b is equals to 1 in this first result. And if you replace a and b with 1, what will happen? Since a is 1, e power ax is e power ax divided by a square plus b square. 1 square plus 1 square is 2, directly I am writing, into a sin bx. A is 1 and b is 1. So a is 1, so 1 sin 1x, that means sin x, minus b is also 1, as well b is 1, okay? And that's why this is what? 1 cos bx, that means cos x. So finally, integral e power x sin x dx is e power x by 2 into sin x minus cos x. And in the same way, you just write this integral e power 2x cos 3x dx. And now to answer this, we need to compare this function e power 2x cos 3x with this e power ax cos bx. And when you compare these two, we need to take what? A is equals to 2 and b is equals to 3. By taking a as 2, b as 3, you just apply this result. What is this result? E power ax by a square plus b square. E power ax in the sense, e power 2x divided by a square plus b square. A is 2 and b is 3. 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, 9 plus 4 is 13 into a cos bx. A is 2, b is 3, so 2 cos 3x plus b sin bx. B is 3, right? And so this is 3 sin 3x. Okay, just observe this and then try to answer this last one. For doubts, you just mention. And this last bit, integral e power ax sin bx plus cos bx dx. So that means e power ax sin bx is this first one. E power ax cos bx is this second one. We need to add these two. That's our answer. If you add these two for this, e power ax by a square plus b square is a common thing. E power ax by a square plus b square into, we need to add these two. When you observe, a sin bx as well, this is what? B sin bx. So, a plus b into sin bx. And the next, for cos bx we need to add, this is a cos bx, this is minus b cos bx. So, this is a minus b cos bx. This is our answer, plus c. For all these things, we need to add the constant of integration as some c, right? Since we are in indefinite integration. Once again, look here. Integral e power ax into sin bx plus cos bx is this e power ax by a square plus b square into a plus b sin bx plus a minus b cos bx plus c. Okay, have a look. I will give you some more different problems as an development of these results. Okay, memorize these two. Using these two, I will give you some different problems. Now, you just observe these two, keep in mind these two, and then try to answer these questions. In the same way as we discussed these proofs or solutions for these two, if you proceed, then its result is simply, this is equals to e power, that linear function ax plus m divided by a square plus b square. You just look there. If you have e power ax by a square plus b square, and if you have e power ax plus m, this is again e power ax plus m by a square plus b square into there a sin bx minus b cos bx, and here a sin of that linear function bx plus n minus b cos of bx plus n plus c. That's it. Okay, just observe the transformation. Okay, how the result e power ax sin bx is changing for e power ax plus m into sin of bx plus m. In the same way, you just try to write this answer using the second one. Okay, you just write it. Next bit, another type, another model related to this e power ax sin bx. Instead of e power ax, if you have a power x into sin bx, how to answer? See, sin bx, okay, a power x. If it is some e power ax type, then it is easy for us to answer. So you need to rewrite this a power x as per our requirement. Okay, for that I need to use some concepts of exponents as well, the laws of logarithms. A power x can be written as e power logarithm of a power x to the base c. I think you all know it. Okay, since these two are equal, again it is equals to a power x. And now you just send x here, so e power x into log a to the base e. So a power x is simply nothing but e power x into log a to the base e. So we have a chance to rewrite this a power x as e power x into log a base e. Then the problem will become integral e power x instead of that. See, this is a power x. Instead of that a power x, we need to write e power log a to the base e into x into sin bx dx. Okay, this is a simple law of exponents as well, logarithms. And now just compare this bit, this problem with the standard one, e power ax sin bx. Sin bx is common, right? Here we have e power x coefficient as a, but here we have e power x coefficient as log a to the base e. Here x coefficient is log a to the base e, there a, you just replace this a with this log a to the base e. Then our answer at the end is e power ax is simply nothing but e power, instead of a, we need to use log a to the base e into x, divided by here a square plus b square. And here instead of a, we need to use this log a to the base e, so divided by log a to the base e whole square plus b square into here a sin bx. This a is coefficient of x, but here we have coefficient of x as log a to the base e. So log a to the base e into sin bx minus b cos bx plus c. So finally, this is our answer. And now this e power log a to the base e into x is simply nothing but a power x only, right? So you just rewrite this numerator as a power x with this result. So finally, integral a power x sin bx dx is nothing but a power x by log a base e whole square plus b square into log a base e into sin bx minus b cos bx. In the same way, it is easy now to answer e power ax into cos bx dx. You just try this. Okay?
And these are some different problems related to e power ax sin bx. Okay? And finally, all these are just applications for the integral e power x into f of x dx, or you may say for integration by parts. All these are just applications for integration by parts. Using the concept of integration by parts, we derived all these formulae and problems related to those formulae. And that's for this part of problems.